we're talking about Beethoven's 8th symphony and its second movement. We are in 1812, and as Beethoven composes this symphony, a famous object was invented by Herr Menzel. This object is a triangle object, and it's a metronome. A metronome is a very, very important object for the musicians today. But at this time, it was very new and very unusual to have the speed of the music, the tempo, as we say, like that given by a mechanical object. So Beethoven decided to make a joke, an homage with this object to the inventor, Herr Menzel. So he composed this first version for a vocal quartet with the name of Menzel. But if we think of the pulse in music, of the tempo, the pulse, the rhythm, it's something that we have since ages. For example, with Steve Reich, 18 musicians. Fourth symphony, let's hear how the winds play very fast, ti-ti-ti-ti-ti-ti-ti, repeated notes. But also in John Adams' Harmony Lehre, when the whole orchestra sounds like a heart beating. Schubert trio. Let's hear how the piano gives to the cello this low marking tempo. And for sure, in Hitchcock, the most famous movie of Hitchcock, in the climax of the film, let's hear some music. There is the pulse in this music, the tribute or the joke to the metronome, and there is a melody, a very almost idiot melody. This melody is around an F, a single note, and he goes down and up. We call that appoggiatura in music, double appoggiatura. Let's hear. And this principle of going around, turning around a note, we have that in Chopin Waltz. So after that, the orchestra goes more and more mechanical and plays louder and louder. So, like every time, you can listen to the whole symphony, for example, on YouTube with Nicolas Harnoncourt and the Chamber Orchestra of Europe. And when I'm thinking about this music, maybe some years after the creation, the premiere of the 8th symphony, another composer, another musician took the lead with this pulse, James Brown. Get up, get over, stay on the scene, get over, like a sex machine, get over.